Hey friends, welcome back to Call Me After Coffee. My name is Brie. If you're new here, welcome. And if you've been around for a while, thanks for coming back. So today I'm doing kind of a funny video, which is just books that I would use as toilet paper. And I just want to say really quickly, a little disclaimer, I don't think that the is funny, and I do understand the gravity of a situation. But for me, and I'm sure there are more of you out there, sometimes either I have to laugh about a situation or I'm gonna cry about a situation. And things are really heavy, and so I meant for this video to be lighthearted, and I hope that it doesn't hurt anyone's feelings or step on any toes. And also, like a forever disclaimer, if any of these books are books that you enjoy, I'm glad that you enjoyed them. I didn't enjoy them, but I mean, somebody out there has to, or they wouldn't have been published, right? So without wasting any more time, I'm gonna jump into the stack now. These are a pile of books that I would use if I ran out of toilet paper. The first book in the stack is one that I don't know if anybody's really even heard of. It's called The Almost Moon by Alice Sebold, who also wrote The Lovely Bones, I think. This book is essentially about this woman who murders her mother and then tries to cover it up, but it's almost written in a way where you're supposed to feel bad for her. It was a really twisted book. It was really weird. I couldn't put it down, but also I really didn't like it, so that one had to make it on the list. The next one is one that you guys know that I really, really hated, and it's The Clockmaker's Daughter by Kate Morton. This book was a bad time for me. It felt badly written, badly put together. I hated everything about it. There was really nothing I could say about it that was positive. I hated every moment that I spent in this book, and then I skipped like 200 pages, read the end, and that's how we ended up with it on this pile. This one is a more recent read that you guys know that I hated because it was also a dumpster fire. This is Longbourn by Jo Baker. This was supposed to be a Pride and Prejudice retelling, but it was not a good time. It was super bad, and I've taken to calling it Longboring instead of Longbourn because I hated this book so much. The next one is An Unwanted Guest by Sherry Lapina. I really didn't like this one. I did not get along with it at all. This was kind of like a really, really bad And Then There Were None ripoff. I really didn't enjoy this, and so there, it has to go on this pile. Into the Water by Paula Hawkins is another one that I really didn't like. I read every single page in this book and I didn't like it at all. I don't remember what I ended up giving it. I think I might have given it a 2. I don't remember. It's been a couple years. So for starters, this one I figured out pretty early on and I ended up being right. And then secondly, it took forever to wrap up, and it wraps up like every single character in the book, even ones that like you don't even care about, like side characters. Everybody is wrapped up at the end. It dragged it out so much. But I really didn't like this book. I didn't like any of the characters. I just thought it was really stupid. Next we have The Cherry Harvest by Lucy Sanna. This one has cheating in it. They try to justify it, makes people do bad things. I didn't like this one. I thought this was gonna be a cute story about some forbidden love between this couple's daughter and a German soldier, and it was not that at all. It got twisted and weird, but not in the kind of ways that I tend to enjoy. I don't mind dark and twisty, but this one was just stupid and bad, and I didn't like it. The writing itself was actually pretty good. Like, I enjoyed the way it was written. I just hated the story that it told. And last but not least, who guessed it? Who guessed it? A Little Life. This is 812 pages of toilet paper, and I hated it. I didn't hate the first 100 pages, but I hated everything after that. You guys know how much I despised this book. I just think that it is harmful in nature. I know a lot of people love it. This is like the BookTube, Bookstagram darling. I'm like one of the only people in the world who hated this book with a violent passion. But I despised this book. I hated everything about it. I hated everything that it kind of stood for. I did not have a good time reading this. And I thought it was gonna be a 5-star when I picked it up, and it ended up being a 1-star, and I skimmed the end. And this was literally just pain for the sake of pain and nothing else. And I'm not about that, so that's why I added this to the list. All right, friends, that's everything that I've got for today's video. I hope that some of you got a chuckle out of it and could take this in the lighthearted way that it was meant. Leave me a comment down below. What book did you hate so much that you would consider using it as toilet paper in a crisis? I would love to know what you guys have to say down below. And while you're down there, if you haven't already, please hit subscribe and the bell so you don't miss future notifications. I upload most Mondays and Thursdays, and I will talk to you guys all next time. Thanks so much.